Welcome to ArcherPoint's Coffee Break. This is a session on who did what and when did they really do it. So that's a question that we get a lot. Who posted this? When did they do it? What did it affect? And this is just a quick session to show you how to find out that information. So what I'm going to do is take a look at a sales order that was posted. And for some reason, it's a mystery to us. We don't know who did it. We don't know when they did it. And we don't know what it affected. So we need to know all these things so that maybe we can reverse it, address the problem, tell the person not to do it again. So we're just going to look at our posted documents. And again, this is a posted sales order or posted sales invoice. And I happen to know it's the last one in my system. So I'm just going to scroll down here to the end. And I'm going to open it up. So my first question is, who did this? So who posted this transaction? It wasn't supposed to be posted yet. And they did it all wrong, and I want to know who it was, so that, of course, I can correct their behavior in the future. So I'm going to click on this drop-down over here and go to Help and click on About This Page. It's also Control-Alt-F1 on your keyboard. So if you click on it, you'll see here you have the table fields. And on the table fields, you see basically every single piece of data associated with this sales invoice. And if I just scroll down here conveniently in alphabetical order, I see the user ID and I say, oh, look, it was me. So this is how we see who posted this transaction. I'm going to go ahead and close this. And now I want to see what was affected. So if I go up here to my navigate button, I can click on Navigate, and Navigate shows me all the areas of the system that were impacted by this posting. So I can look at the posted sales invoice, which I'm looking at right now. I can look at the GL entries. I can look at the tax entries. I can look at the customer ledger entry and the detail of the customer ledger entry and the value entries. So what I'm really interested in right now is the GL entry. So I'm going to click on GL entry, and then I'm going to go to Show Related Entries. So I see here all my debits and credits. I see exactly which GL accounts were affected by this posting and for what amount. So if I needed to reverse something, I could use this sort of as a guideline to make any journal entries, things like that. The other thing that I see here is that the posting date is September of 2017, which is unlikely because this is 2016. So what I want to see is, when did this person actually do this? I'm seeing that the posting date is 2017. That's a mistake. And I want to see when this transaction was actually created. So we're getting into the when did this happen. One thing I want to make note of while I'm in the general ledger entries is the entry number. So the entry number is assigned by the system. No one has control over it. So it gets assigned automatically, and it's always sequential. And it actually will cue us in as to which register we're about to look at. We're going to go to the general ledger registers. And we're going to look for these entry numbers. And then we'll be able to see when the transaction was actually created. So you'll just make a note of the range of entry numbers. And then I'm going to back up out of here. I'm pressing Escape. And you can go to either the department and look up the register, or you can type in GL registers up in your search box. So I'm going to go to the department and go to Sales and Marketing. Archive, because that's where all of our history lives. And there we have GL registers. Again, if I had just put in the search box GL registers, it would have taken me there. So if I go down here to the bottom, I see these last two registers, and I see those entry numbers that we saw from the general ledger entry. I see the 2600 through 2603. These were the entries that were created, and what I note here is that the creation date was August 31st of 2016, not September 10th of 2017. So somebody probably had a typo and put the wrong date in, but I can tell when it actually occurred. So if I'm looking at my finances or my financials, and I see that, you know, when we originally printed them, they were okay, and now they're not, you can come in here to see that somebody maybe backdated something or put something into a future date, and it's throwing off your numbers. This can help you in that regard. So that concludes our who, what, and when. We got to see who posted the transaction, what happened when they posted the transaction, and when did it really occur by going to the register. Thanks for joining us for our coffee break.
Thanks for watching this ArcherPoint video. If you found it helpful, make sure to check out our website and blog at www.archerpoint.com. Additionally, if you have any questions regarding our products, services, or information in this video, feel free to email us at info@archerpoint.com. Thanks.